Doug Hawking, head coach of the Vancouver Island Raiders, joining me now. And the Raiders face a first-round test on the road against the Langley Rams. And, Doug, I want to go back to a couple of points from the season finale, the win over the Huskers. And, first of all, the two just monster performances from a couple of your kids. I want to start with Rhett Williams. Just talk about what it was like to watch that guy rack up about 247 yards against the Huskers.
Yeah, pretty awesome performance by Rhett. We'd known all year that Rhett's the type of back that can have games and days like that. So, coming off of being pretty nicked up for a few weeks and resting him, it was great to see him get in there behind his O-line and pound out some hard yards between the tackles. Also nice to see him bounce the ball outside and show a little bit of speed and show everybody that ankle's healthy and he's ready to go. So, it's pretty happy to see, pretty proud of that kid, the way he kind of sat back and, everybody wants to be on the field. And for two or three weeks now, Rhett's been telling us, I'm ready. But we've been kind of sitting back going, well, there's some big games coming. Let's make sure that foot and that ankle is 100%. And I think he showed us that he's ready to go on Saturday there.
The other side of the ball was Guy Van McNally Hardesty, defensive back out of Mount Doug. I mean, a wild game. I don't know if I've seen a defensive player impact so many different ways with three interceptions, a forced fumble, and that fumble literally took points off the board. Then he got the blocked punt in there as well. I mean, that's got to be one of the all-time performances in Raider defensive history, Doug.
Yeah, we've had some pretty good defensive performances over the years, and
he Kareem, stepped up. Coach Mayer is going to be pissed at me for that, but
there might be a few guys on defense. Yeah. I think there's a linebacker in Calgary that might be pretty pissed at you for that one too. G had a great day. He's outstanding third-year player. He's doing everything we're asking of him right now, and he just at this time of year to see him go out, I'm so proud of him, and he's bought into his technique and he's into the process, and you can just see it's paying off every week for him and he's playing better and better. And we've been building to this point, and I'm really looking forward to see what's in store for the kid this week.
So that's all great. There's a lot of positivity. You guys are coming out of the regular season with a victory, but you're on the road and you're facing a Langley team that just beat you in that park a couple of weeks ago. How do you need to change your approach, or do you need to change your approach to get the better of the Rams based on the way things went in the Week 9 matchup?
Well, I think we need to finish drives. We didn't do that. We gave our offense opportunities, when we were there last time at midfield, and we took a couple of sacks and we went two and out too many times. We need to convert on second down, and we need to get first downs and move the ball and keep our defense off the field. As poorly as we played, we still felt what we were in that football game in the fourth quarter. And then finally, they got some points towards the end there, and that was I'm going to take that and say that our defense was on the field so much that they just wore down. So our offense needs to convert on second down, keep the defense off the field, and then get points when we're supposed to get points. We're real excited. We feel that we're really healthy. And Langley's a good football team. Langley will bring their A game, and they'll force us to bring ours. The benefit about it is that we have a lot of guys that have been in this situation before, and it's an old story, a third place team. We've been down this road before, and we're thriving at the opportunity to get on the road. This team travels well, and I'm excited about seeing how they're going to come out on Saturday.
Yeah, you just sort of set up my next question, and you guys were in the same spot last year, and you did something that doesn't get done very often. You went up to the Apple Bowl and won, and then you went to West Shore and won on the road twice to win the BC Championship, and a lot of guys were part of that, like you just said. Are the guys talking about that? Are you hearing that buzz? We did this. We know what this is all about.
I'm not listening to it. I don't hear it. I think privately in the locker room, the guys may be saying, hey, we've been down this road before. But they're practiced. The way they're practicing right now is it's a playoff atmosphere, and so it should be. But it's an atmosphere of, we've done this before. The intensity's up in practice. Playoff football is a little bit faster. It's a little bit more intense. The hits are a little harder. And like I said, the guys have been down this road before, and they're excited to get back on the field and play against the team, a tough opponent, and prove to some people that just because we finished in third place, don't count this team out. Don't sleep on us, because we're coming ready to play.
What do you think of the other matchup? The Huskers go up to the Apple Bowl. You know, there's a lot of intrigue, I think, there, and a lot of ways that game could go. What's your take on that?
Well, the Apple Bowl is always a tough place to play, right? So, you know, for Chilliwack, you know, I think, you know, this time of year, this comes down to experience. This comes down to teams that have been in this situation before. And, you know, as far as I'm concerned, you know, Chilliwack's got a good football team. If they can stay in it and, you know, keep it close in the fourth quarter, I think it's going to be a great football game. That's, to be quite honest, Tom, I really don't care about that football game. I'm not thinking about it. You know, if you're looking for an answer, you're talking to the wrong guy. You know, I got one game on my mind right now, and that's the Langley Rams.
Well, you humored me, so I appreciate that.
I do my best, buddy.
I'll ask you to do that again here, because I've asked Howie Zarin and Ben McCauley this question, and I'm going to ask Bob Reese too, and I want to throw it to you, and I'll tell you what the other coaches said after, but I'll ask you first. Okay. Is there a favorite to win the Cullen Cup right now, based on who's left, the four teams?
No. No, there isn't. I think every game's a coin toss. You know, I'm not even going to say that home field gives you any type of advantage right now. If you look at how close the league was this year, any one of these four teams can win on any given day. So, as far as I'm concerned, it's the team that's going to go out and execute at the highest level, protect the football, limit turnovers, and capitalize on chances to put points on the board. Though that's the team who's favored to win the Cullen Cup.
Well, you matched Ben McCauley. He agreed with you. And Howie Zarin, with a smile on his face, put it back on the sun and said, they're the sun. They're supposed to win this thing. So I think they exactly. Both stuck the script pretty well, right?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Okay, Doug, well, thank you for this. Best of luck and enjoy the game. I really appreciate your time here again, as always.
Yeah, no problem, Dahmer, anytime.